No, we'll keep putting the chart up no matter how often they rip it down. And if they dock us points, we'll retaliate by taking points off them. And all the time, they'll be wondering what's going to happen to the lucky loser.
To my elder daughter, Judy May Bryant, and with it my eternal prayers for her forgiveness, I bequeath the residue of my estate after settlement of all my outstanding debts. After that, he goes on to set down all the terms and conditions that would apply if you were unable or unwilling to accept the bequest. Your sister and her family would...
Did he ask my forgiveness?
Yes, that's what he said.
Oh, God.
I'm going to kill you!
He was only trying to be fair to everybody.
Were you fair to Pop? All I ever wanted from him was his love.
Oh, sure you did. That's why you broke his heart, you filthy pervert! Even if we wanted you back, all we ever wanted was the money. You make me sick every time you look at me. Judy! Stop it! Judy!
She's crazy. She tried to kill me.
Please go.
Oh, I'll go, all right. I'll go straight to the cops. She's a psychopath. I'm going to make sure she's locked up again.
Judy, why did you attack her like that? Your own sister.
She offered me everything. Everything I'd lost in the last 20 years. My family. Forgiveness, even love.
Then what?
Have you any idea what that meant to me?
Well, I know what a family means.
She's a bloody liar. She's a bloody liar. As soon as she finds out that Dad left me the money, then suddenly she loves me.
And you think Frances was after your money?
Because she's after my money. I would have given it to her. I would have given it to her. But oh no. She impersonates me to a solicitor so that I won't find out that the money was really mine. Of course, I lost my head. Now I've blown everything.
You don't know that for sure. I don't think she was very badly hurt.
Oh, she's still going to go assault for me, isn't she? You know what that means? Oh, God.
Well, you don't know that for sure. She may be just as worried about getting into trouble as you are.
Why? It's because she has impersonated me?
Well, from what you've told me, it was misrepresentation with intent to defraud.
Don't be stupid! I'm an ex-con! Can't you remember that? Do you think that the police are going to listen to one single thing I have to say when she has you for a witness?
How's it going?
They are, I reckon that'll do. Looks just like the other chart, except for Ferguson's score, of course.
What'd you give her?
10 points off.
How come? For ripping up the other chart, you dummy.
I better get this back to the rec room then.
Well, that's stupid.
Who asked you?
Well, why don't you put it up at lunchtime?
Because I don't want no one seeing me putting it up, do I?
Makes sense to me.
That way I know where to start looking if I get dobbed. All I said was
we know,
stupid...
we heard you. What are you looking so happy about?
I'm just thinking about the solicitor who's supposed to be coming in.
You're not fighting it, are you?
I don't know. That's the trouble.
Well, suit yourself if you ask me. I reckon you should wear the verbal and go for a light sentence.
She won't get a light nothing when Nola gets back.
Oh, shut up, Trixie.
She's right, though. There's no telling what that mad bitch will do when she gets out of solitary.
You stick with me. You'll be okay.
You better be right or I'm knackered.
Well, I'm getting sick and tired of you being such a sook. At least you've got mates. I know plenty of people who'd swap places with you any day of the week.
Yeah, Nola for one.
There. That'd do nicely.
What are you doing here?
Mrs. Bell, you didn't half give me a turn.
Well?
Well, I was just on my way back to the laundry.
That doesn't explain what you're doing here.
I left a packet of smokes behind.
You are assigned to work in the laundry, not ramble around the corridors. Get back there.
Straight away, Mrs. Powell.
And Latham?
Yeah?
You've lost your point for today.
Oh, what for?
You want to try for five?
No, Mrs. Powell.
Yes, very clever, Latham. Just found this in the rec room. You don't seem to be too popular.
Yeah, it's almost identical to the one I took down last night, apart from my score.
Well, why wasn't I told?
I'm sorry, I didn't think it was important at the time.
No, no, it's probably just a prank to needle us.
Well, are you going to do anything about it?
No, don't think so.
Well, surely they'll lose all their points.
Why? You've just finished telling me you didn't think it was very important, and I'm inclined to agree with you. Now, I think it's best that we just let them know we're not very amused. Otherwise, they're only going to feel they've achieved something.
Thank you. I'm afraid you're right, Judy.
She's pressing charges.
She's made a statement to the police, and they're waiting for the Justice of the Peace.
A JP? What for?
Well, the police don't like to prosecute in domestic arguments.
Domestic? I could have killed her.
Well, you didn't hurt her badly, and she is your sister.
Hmm. That's my bad luck, isn't it?
Well, I think the police worry about family witnesses changing their minds before court.
Are you kidding? My family would queue a week to see me go under. Does that mean she's taken me to court?
Well, technically, yes, but the police will make all the arrangements. I'm sorry, Judy. I wish I could help you.
I'm going to end up back in your damn prison, you realize that? And I have worked so bloody hard.
Yes, I know.
Do you? I know I made a mess of my life. I know most of it was my fault, but it never started out like that. And now, I'm going to be sent back to jail by my own sister.
Perhaps I'd better leave.
Mrs. Before. Davidson.
You were the only witness. Maybe if you said that
Judy?
You
Judy?
You don't think it's fair on me, do you?
Do you realize what you're asking?
Too much?
I'm sorry.
So am I. Well, I'll go down to the cop station. Beat's waiting for him.
I'll drive you.
I wonder if there's a reward out for a dangerous ex-con like me.
Judy, where are you going?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson. I think it's just instinct. I can't wait to get away from that place. Thanks for going bail for me.
Don't thank me, thank the PRG.
Well, I never thought the cops would let me off that easily.
Well, obviously they're not interested in two sisters fighting each other.
Yeah, well, that's not what my parole officer's gonna say.
Wait till you see him face to face. Telephone conversations are never satisfactory.
No. You've been great, Mrs. Davidson. Thank you very much.
Come on, I'll drive you home.
G'day. Well, a fine example for the other girls, aren't I?
There's no point in going on about it.
The first sign of any problems and I go the bash. I mean, how can I expect them to behave?
I'll pour some coffee.
Oh, thanks, Mrs. Davidson. Gas, electricity. I don't think it matters anymore.
Is something wrong?
I'm a grandma.
Laurie?
Yeah, it's a boy. 7 pounds, 14 ounces.
Oh, Judy, that's wonderful news.
Oh, but why now? Why, when everything is falling apart, does it have to be now?
Well, things may work out. At least it's good news.
It certainly is that. Hey, What do you know? Grandma Bryant.